Hello, welcome back to the channel. We are on the letter X. Can you guys believe that we are like almost there? Wow. Today's dog is very interesting. It is the only dog that starts with the letter X, so no surprise there. It is also called a Mexican hairless dog, but their real name is very long. I'll put it on the screen because I'm not even going to attempt it. So I'm just going to call them the short version, which is a Xolo. Okay, so let's put 2 minutes on the clock and let's get it started. Okay, so the Xolo is believed to be one of the oldest dog breeds in the world, with a history dating back more than 3,000 years. The breed's origins can be traced to pre-Columbian Mesoamerica, particularly in the regions that are now present-day Mexico. So if you've seen Coco, then I'm sure you'll recognize this dog. The name of this dog comes from Aztec origin, and it means god dog. Xolo played a significant role in the cultures of ancient Mesoamerican civilizations, such as the Aztec and the Mayans. These dogs were highly revered and were considered sacred beings. They were believed to have healing properties and were often used in traditional medicine to treat various ailments. Additionally, they were thought to guide the souls of the deceased through the afterlife. Because of this, they were frequently buried with their owners to accompany them in the journey to the next world. Xolos had deep symbolic and ritualistic significance in Mesoamerican cultures, and they were associated with various deities such as the god of lightning and death, and they were frequently depicted in poetry, sculptures, and other artworks. With the arrival of Spanish conquistadors in the 16th century, the Xolo faced a decline in numbers. The invading Europeans brought their own dog breeds, and the interbreeding between the Xolos and these imported dogs threatened the purity of the breed. Despite facing near extinction, the Xolo survived in some remote regions of Mexico where they continued to be kept by local communities. In the 1950s, the interest in the breed was revived, and efforts to preserve and promote the Xolo began. The breed's unique appearance, historical significance, and loyal temperament attracted dog enthusiasts and breeders worldwide. The Xolo was recognized by the Mexican Kennel Club in 1956, and in 2010, the American Kennel Club officially recognized the breed in the United States. While the Xolo retains some of its ancient characteristics, it is primarily kept as a beloved companion and show dog in contemporary times. They come in three sizes, the toy, the miniature, and the standard, and two varieties, the hairless and coated. The hairless variety has smooth, soft, and mostly hairless skin, while the coated variety has a short, flat coat. Although the Xolo may be low maintenance in the grooming department, their skin may need protection from sunburn and cold temperatures, and occasional bathing and moisturizing are necessary to keep their skin healthy. Xolos are moderate in their energy levels, and they are not hyperactive dogs, but they do enjoy regular exercise and playtime like any dog, and daily walks and interactive play sessions are generally sufficient to keep them physically and mentally stimulated. This is the finished painting, and I think this is one of my favorite dogs that I have painted. It was just challenging, but also kind of rewarding, and it was very unique, so I really liked it, and I hope you guys learned something new about Xolo dogs. I definitely did, and they're really cool. If anybody has one, please leave your experience with the breed down below in the comment section, and I would love to read about it. Thank you so much. See you on the next one.